This is a 2000 lumen rechargeable battery made by Nebo called the Slide King 2K. We're going to have a discussion about it and find out if this thing is practical or not. Hey, what's going on? It's Matt. Welcome back to the channel. This is the Nebo Slide King 2K. This is a 2000 lumen flashlight that is rechargeable by USB-C. They give you a cord in the packaging, and I wanted to talk about this flashlight, show you some of the features. It doubles as a work light. I used to have one of these. I still have it, actually. I should take that back. It was non-rechargeable and only went to 500 lumens, and I've been on the market looking for a higher lumen flashlight because I walk my dog at night and I want to be visible because there are cars. And I do live on side streets and cars kind of go by pretty fast and I want us to be visible for obvious reasons. But this little sucker here comes in at 7.5 inches. The weight of it, this thing weighs a ton. You could literally knock somebody out with this thing if they ever approached you and you felt like your life was in danger or you needed a weapon of some sort. It's very well built. Really great rubberized grip right here. The back right there is magnetic. It does stick to anything, obviously, that's metal. And some aluminum, if you don't know, sometimes magnetic things will stick to aluminum. I wasn't aware of that. Maybe you were, but I wasn't. I thought it was only steel and heavier metals, so to speak. But as mentioned in the title of the flashlight, the 2K stands for 2000 lumens. It casts a very, very bright light. And that light can go anywhere up to, they say, 1300 feet. That is with the flashlight on high and the 4K pushed out, so you have a little bit more of a spotlight. I tested it in this local park that's by my house earlier tonight just to see, and I measured it out. It's roughly 1200 feet that you can clearly see something when it is on high and basically, you know, fully zoomed in, so to speak. To lower the flashlight, you're going to push the on button right here and you're going to hold it and it'll slowly dim and then it'll just blink and then you're at 200 lumens. Now I want to stop right there with this. Those are the only two modes in regular flashlight mode that this one has. You go from either 2000 lumens to 200. There's no in between. That's pretty drastic in my opinion, and it's drastic enough to where if you're using at night and you're on the 2000 and you lower it, your eyes do have to adjust and it seems very, very dim and almost useless, to be honest with you. The 2000 lumens when it's on the high setting, which is what it turns on automatically at, that will only last you for 2 hours. The 200 lumen will last you a longer time, obviously. I think it's up to 60 hours, but my headlamps are stronger than 200 lumen, and they're a lot lighter than this, and they hold a charge actually longer. My Petzl rechargeable headlamps hold a charge longer, and obviously, functionality-wise, I'm not carrying, you know, a headlamp. But one of the things that they really do like about this flashlight is it doubles as a work light. If you just pull it apart like that, you have a 500 lumen work light. Push the button one time, it goes to a red mode. Push it again, it goes to a strobe mode. And then if you hold it back down again, it goes back to the white. You can also lower it and get it down to, I believe it is a 40 lumen work light, to which honestly, maybe would be good in a certain situation if you were in a totally pitch black situation and you needed a light for, I don't know, let's just say a couple of hours. It's a good light. But where am I going to put this? Where am I really going to use this? I can't put this in the car, to be honest with you. And that's really what I got it for as a secondary. Because obviously the magnetic piece and the work light piece makes it kind of like, oh, I can use this if I ever need to do something on the side of the road to my car. That's where the old one was. And it worked out okay, but I always kept forgetting to bring extra batteries. And when the batteries would run out, because it does get cold in Northern California sometimes, batteries drain quicker, I would have a very useless flashlight. So one of the things I wanted to talk about in this video is not just this particular flashlight, and that's really the flashlight in a nutshell. It's great. Look, if you need something that's going to be super bright, that's only going to last for 2 hours, I would say get it. If you need a flashlight that has a little bit less lumens and you want it to last longer, I wouldn't look at this particular flashlight simply for the fact that you go from 2,000 to 200. That just doesn't make sense to me. Why would there not be a 500 thrown in there, or at least an 1,000 to knock it down and give me 4 hours of runtime? It doesn't make a lot of sense the way that they designed this particular flashlight in that sense. So I would recommend buying it if you're going to use it for what I'm primarily using it for, which is walking the dog, which is at midnight is usually just a 20-minute walk, and it lasts me a whole week on one charge. And I use it on high all the time, just because I like how bright it is and how much of a cast it throws. So in that aspect, yeah. But if you needed a flashlight for your, you know, for anything else, like for your car, like let's just go back to the car incidents. If you needed this to put in your car, I would not trust it, to be honest with you. I would look at a different flashlight. It doesn't have to be not Nebo. I'm not bashing Nebo, but in this sense, I don't think this light is super practical for anybody who just doesn't need to use it for a couple of hours. And by that, I mean, this is really meant to be used in 30-minute intervals and have a close charging station or some other place to charge it. And that kind of leads me up to the general discussion of this video, is that it's great to have high lumen flashlights and it's great to have them be rechargeable. But at the end of the day, the higher the lumen, the quicker the battery is going to go. Not unless you want to get one of those big like Olight or Streamlight, like just honkers that are basically like old, huge, you know, like almost like cop lights, you know, that they put on the side of cop cars that you can carry. So it's not really what I want a flashlight for. I want a flashlight so I can be put in a backpack or put in a place in a car or in a home or in a tent somewhere, and I can get to it and it can throw a lot of light. So if I was camping with this, I would definitely make sure that I had plenty of battery banks to charge it, because my gut would tell me that I would need it probably for 2 hours every night on that high setting. And like I said, if there was a 500 or 1,000 lumen piece to this that was on the actual flashlight side, because the work light is 500 lumens, that's fantastic. But I'm not going to walk around holding it like this. It doesn't throw that far, even though it's 500 lumens, just because the way that the work light is designed, it's not meant to go far. It's meant to spread out in a short distance. So it's $51 right now on Amazon. It's a great Christmas gift for dads and for people who like the outdoors, and maybe someone just like me who got a dog and needed some light at night. But the Nebo Slide King 2K, take a look at it. Buy it, don't buy it. I just wanted to gripe about it, I think. So hope everyone's having a great night. Talk to you soon.